Hi, I'm Katie Siskind. I'm a licensed marriage and family therapist and a yoga teacher. I own a practice, Wisdom Within Counseling, in Niantic, Connecticut. I personally specialize with distant couples who have a really strong foundation of trust and friendship and commitment, but have lost that spice and that desire and playfulness. I have two amazing therapists who are experts with children and teens, and they love helping kids who are anxious, tend to want to avoid school, withdraw, feel depressed. So Sarah loves helping kids with ADHD, and Courtney loves working with teenagers who are self-harming, who have a struggling with eating disorder, body image issues, young women who are kind of feeling depressed, insecure, have a major inner critic needing to work on to build that self-confidence. So this video is going to offer you three tips to improve your couple relationship or your marriage. So tip number one, talk with your feelings and stay connected to your heart. So if you talk, oftentimes we're talking from the past. So like you might be upset about something that happened at work, and now you're trying to talk to your partner after a long day. So all of that resentment, that stress, that aggression from work gets carried into the conversation that you're having with your partner. Let's say after your day ends at 6 p.m., you see your partner, he or she is the first person that you see, and now they say, oh, how are you? And you say, oh, just, I had such a rough day. Like, that aggression does not need to be put on your partner. So when you speak, speak from your heart. Use an I feel statement rather than an I am statement. So if you say, I am hungry, right, that embodies your whole being. Instead, say, I feel hungry. You know, like, could we work together to tackle this? You know, team up. So this leads me to tip number two, is to team up against a problem. What happens in marriages and with couples is that a problem divides the two, or however many partners you have, we'll say two people in this instance. So the problem divides both people. So for instance, let's say someone has to pick a child up at school, right? Can't make the bus. So parent number one says, I can't, I have work. Parent number two says, well, I can't, I have soccer. And so this now is a problem that has come between the two of them. Rather, instead, a much healthier way of working through this would be to team up. So imagine this problem is like a villain and you two are the superheroes and you have to figure out a plan to get this villain. So the problem really is then the picking up of after school for this child. So teaming up together, you would say, well, could I move my soccer? Or could I go out with friends after work at a different time? Or what about, you know, having your mom do it? Or how about the babysitter? Like, working through it together, having a conversation, even if it's difficult, will help you and your partner feel closer and improve trust. Tip number three is don't use defensiveness. So defensiveness actually breaks attachment, and we're trying to build attachment through trust here in a couple unit, in a marriage, in a partnership. So you don't want to do anything maliciously to break trust. And one of those things would be being defensive. So if your partner says, I really don't like having these dishes in the sink. I really don't like how you do this. I really think we need to be cleaner here. And it starts going on. Then you could get defensive and you could say, well, I didn't leave that mess. But would that be helping the trust, or would that be creating disconnect? It would be creating disconnect. The true thing to say, really, when you want to create a trusting relationship, is to be self-aware. And that means using compassion to say, again, teaming up to say, you know, I really, I totally understand. I don't like living in a messy place either. What could we do? When could we clean this up together? Let's put on some playlist, right? You can get involved with your partner, get on the same page, build that trust, create meaningful relationships. And also from this place of commitment that you already have, you can spice up your relationship. You can, you know, get a little bit into that sexuality component. You can, you know, work together rather than feeling disconnected, misunderstood, and which only turns into frustrating fights. So if you're looking for unique couples holistic therapy in Niantic, Connecticut, I'd love to help you out. My phone number is 860-451-9364. You can call or text to get started. Or if you're looking to read more about parenting articles, co-parenting tips, tips for a healthy marriage, four things not to do in a marriage, articles about teens and eating disorders, you can read at wisdomwithinct.com. I'm Katie Ziskind, and I hope you have a great day.